بزعل موهر داسك وكافاس قلت ساسك أطرفيس كوجك نور نقفرك فيكسيس يازك كريفو.
You could have picked up some Trandoshan sickness on our travels. What are you planning? The scorekeeper's herald should witness such an act of reverence.
I never thought I'd say it, but good riddance to Nar Shaddaa. Nobody on that wretched moon has a speck of imagination. Take my little business. If I wasn't building devices to cheat the casinos, I was being nagged for new weapons.
I imagine only heavily armed cheaters prosper on Nar Shaddaa.
Quite. Everyone has a system. Few have an escape plan.
Now, we get to travel in the most darling ship. Although, I can't bear your ship's computer architecture. It's so frumpy. Mind if I give it a little flair?
If it makes you feel more welcome, go ahead.
Oh, good. I know just where to start. That horrible algorithm for the hyperdrive.
Holiday has quite the talent for making herself at home. Better leave her to it. Now, I'm sure there are more stimulating matters for you to attend to. Just one moment, Jedi. Holiday's latest viral safeguards need to upload. Quite a weighty update this week.
Mm-hmm. Someone's been busy. I should give this my full attention. Good night.
Ah, Holiday. You are unique indeed.
She mentioned being more than a hologram, but little else.
Holiday? She's a holographic life form. Alive in all important ways, but without the inconveniences of a physical body. Her former owner never appreciated Holiday's potential. That's a hut for you.
You'd crossed paths with the Hutt cartel before we met?
Oh no, I encountered him on Hutta. Glorzo, his name was. He collected rare technology, but he thought Holiday was just a novelty hologram. Imagine. I made a generous offer, but some scavenger had already struck a deal for her. So, Glorzo saw the chance for a little fun.
What happened then?
Glorzo proposed a contest. The scavenger and I would head into the Val asteroid field, hopefully surviving more than 2 minutes. The first to bring back a stone from the Rukabi Major asteroid would win Dear Holiday.
I hear approaching Rukabi Major is suicidal. There's too much debris around it.
I had the last laugh. Clever piloting is no match for knowing certain navigational algorithms. I got the stone, returned days before the scavenger, and exchanged it for Sweet Holiday.
So you heroically rescued Holiday from the grip of a cruel hut and won her heart.
Someday it'll make an excellent holonovel. Still, this is all past. And you, my Jedi, have provided a most invigorating change for my usual activities.
That's very gracious.
Sadly, I often find words inadequate to fully express myself.
Jedi, the Council sees you've arrived on Tatooine. Good. We can't waste any time. Tatooine is a vast desert world where survival is often precarious. Master Eris Vossen, one of the Jedi's best cultural explorers, was there when he dropped out of contact with the Council.
What exactly does a cultural explorer do?
The Jedi Council relies on people like Master Eris to develop relationships with the varied cultures of the galaxy. He can understand and adapt to even the most strange and violent societies. If this illness has claimed him, It would be a great loss to the Jedi Order and threaten the groups he was sent to study.
I won't let you down.
Eris hired a guide to help him navigate Tatooine's treacherous deep desert and make contact with its residents. One of Master Eris's last reports was that his guide had developed the sand rot, an illness caused by prolonged, repeated desert exposure. The guide's name is Rowan Delk, and he is currently recuperating at the Dreviat Outpost Medical Center. He's your best lead.
Consider it done.
Work quickly. Master Eris is vital to the Order. And if he has this plague, well, you, more than any of us, know what that means.
Tyrants, damn tyrants, the lot of you. Treating a grown man like he's a baby, like he can't take care of himself.
Lie down, Delk, and quit roaring. I swear, a rancor with heartburn would make less noise than you.
I'll make as much noise as I want. Hey, Jedi! You a friend of Master Eris? Get Darth Nurse here off my back, will you?
Master Eris is exactly the reason I've come to talk to you.
You two can talk, but don't let him fool you into letting him walk, Jedi. He's got the sand rot, and bad.
My man breathes in a little sand, and after 20 years guiding folks through the desert, he suddenly can't make decisions for himself. What's it you wanted to know about Master Eris?
It's a bit of a long story.
I'm listening. Jedi plague? I'm begging your pardon, but I don't believe it. Sure, maybe some masters, but not Master Eris. He's the brightest, most level-headed guy I ever met.
We've seen this illness twist even the most level-headed Jedi Master.
Look, you want to talk to him, you're welcome to it, but I'm telling you, he's just as sane as you or me. When I left him, he was in the desert with them annoying little Jawas. I really impressed him how they managed to survive out there.
I'll go talk to these Jawas, then.
They're friendly folk, the Jawas. Even if they don't understand the meaning of the words private property, if Master Eris isn't still with them, I'm sure they'll help you find them.
What can you tell me of this other Jedi? Why did Master Eris instruct you to build war machines? I think I know this desert walker. If I help you get your parts back, will you help me find the war maker? Give me the message, and you'll get your parts. I am quite honored.
Oh, there, Jedi. Would you look at this? They let me walk around the clinic. Soon they might let me cross the street by myself. Any luck finding Master Eris?
I didn't find him, but the Jawas said he made this for you.
What's this? A message from Master Aerys? I know this encryption. Shouldn't take long to crack. There. Care to see what he has to say?
Rowan, you've realized by now that I've left those most resourceful of creatures, the Jawas, in pursuit of greater things. I came to Tatooine to discover the secret to life. Not its creation, but its ongoing survival. How do some species thrive while others fail? A great darkness is coming, Rowan, and to withstand it, we must know the answer to that question.
That phrase is familiar. Has Master Aerys spoken of this darkness before?
Well, not to me, but there's more here. Maybe he explains it.
I believe that the Jawas, whose enduring civilization thrives in spite of Tatooine's harsh conditions, would answer that question. But during my daily meditation beneath the pillars, I saw a vision on the cave wall that showed me the error of my assumptions. I now know the true original people of Tatooine, the warriors whose knowledge I will use to stem the coming darkness.
What is he talking about? Who are these people he's gone to?
You really want to find this guy, don't you? I don't get it. Sounds perfectly sane to me. Master Aerys used to take lights out to a cave near the rock pillars at night and meditate. Sounds like that's when he had his vision. Yeah, you're a Jedi. Maybe you could do the same thing.
Visions don't exactly work that way, but I should have a look at this meditation site.
You can use my old dragon flares as lights. The cave gets pretty dark. Just be careful out there. Rumor is sand people are getting riled up. Don't let them catch you with your lightsaber sheathed.
Did it work? Did you see Master Aerys' vision?
What Master Aerys saw wasn't mystical at all. It was a carving made by the Sand People.
A carving? Now, Master Air has never mentioned a carving on those walls. What did it show?
Let's see if I can explain this.
I'm listening. The Sand People are the oldest group on Tatooine? Doesn't say much for progress. Still, I bet none of them get the sand rot. I have a hard time believing Master Ares would do anything so cockeyed as working with the Sand People. At least the Jawas are good for droid repair.
I just need to find him, to make sure he's okay.
Wait. What did you say the symptoms of this thing were? Delusions? Paranoia? What, violence? One group of Sand People has been unusually aggressive lately. Normally they stick pretty close to their camps. I'm not saying I think Master Ares is behind it, but maybe it's worth looking into.
So where would I find these Sand People?
There's a farm and settlement out at Malcolm's Dunes that's been reporting a lot of Sand People activity. I'll meet you out there. I know some of those folks, and I can help your investigation.
I thought you weren't supposed to go out into the desert.
Says who? Bunch of doctors never set foot outside of Anchorhead in their lives? Besides, it'll do me good. Don't care if it kills me. I'm tired of being an invalid.
Listen, Delk, we got broken vaporators, a pile of wounded, and our food stores are almost completely gone.
That lunatic said he was a Jedi and a friend of yours. We trusted him.
You better have a pretty good explanation for why this Master Ares keeps sending Sand People out to attack us.
That's the Jedi I'm looking for. Where is he?
Another Jedi? Damn it, Delk. Why do you keep leading them here?
Listen here. We've already lost too much to that Master What's-His-Face and his army of Sand People.
So why don't you just leave here, quiet-like, and don't cause any more trouble?
I don't want trouble. Just tell me what's going on.
I'm sorry, Jedi, but our trust is a bit worse for the wear at this point.
Well, Master Ares was nice enough when he came through asking to study the Sand People.
But ever since we pointed him to their camp, you could set your chrono by their attacks. We got nothing left.
The Sand People are your enemies, not me.
You suggesting we go out there and attack the Sand People? You want us to get killed?
Then tell me where Master Ares is so I can stop him. It's your only chance.
You know it's true, Malcolm.
Okay, fine. Seems we don't have a choice. I'll draw you a map, but I still don't trust you. I'll warn you, though. Master Ares did something to these Sand People. They're stronger. Faster than any we've seen.
Well, I think I know where that is. I'll get some gear together and meet you out there. Maybe provide backup.
You have my gratitude.
Still can't believe the Master Ares I worked with is the same guy who's causing so much trouble.
Yeah. Jedi, you're about to witness it. After weeks of work, finally, an end to the darkness. These people, these marvelous, marvelous specimens, have been tested, no, purified, in the crucible of Tatooine's harsh environs. They alone are the hope of the galaxy. Their strength, their society, is the blueprint of our salvation.
Master Ares, you are very ill.
No, not ill, not ill at all. They are simple, but long after the Empire and the Republic are gone, these people will remain. Their culture is built around strength. They cut the weak away like a societal cancer. Don't you see? It's the only way.
Lord Vivekar has his fangs in you. Deep.
How can I make you understand? They are the ultimate warriors purified by hardship. We must follow their example and cut away everything that would make us weak in the face of our adversaries. The frail, the diseased.
You're not thinking straight. Now, look, I'm sick, Ares. You gonna cast me out too?
I have no choice. We must fortify the Republic with its strongest members and send this army of light out against the darkness.
You are not yourself. These are not your thoughts.
You fools! To oppose me is to reveal your own weakness. You will be cast out. No, wait. Before you strike the killing blow, listen to me. I hear Lord Vivica's voice. I've failed him. Just as I failed my old friend Parcanus when he died.
Why does everyone mention Parcanus?
I don't know, but I keep thinking about our first mission. Our ill-fated mission to Malachor III. We were all weak. We all came under the thrall of the dark side. We did things we regretted, but Parcanus was our strength. As we tried to escape, I fell behind, and he ran back to save me. He became trapped. We had to leave him. It was my weakness that killed him.
It's hard to lose a friend like that, but you have to move on.
I'm trying to. That is the purpose of this project. Think about it. The Jedi Order spends so much time protecting the helpless and caring for the sick when we could be fighting the Empire. You must kill me. I was weak on Malachor III, and I'm weak now. But you must take my findings before the Council. Promise me that.
Let's see how you feel once Lord Vivekar no longer has a hold on you.
What? What was that? He's gone. Somehow you've driven Lord Vivekar away. I no longer hear his voice. I almost wish you hadn't done that. Lord Vivekar twisted my mind, and I'm glad to be free of him. Still, my discovery remains. From these sand people, I have learned the key to building the unstoppable army. I feel I must bring these findings to the Republic. Yet, I can't shake this feeling that some truths are best left buried in the sand.
Using this information would mean the sacrifice of every good the Republic stands for.
You're right. These records are no more. Thank you for your guidance and for saving me from Vivekar's grasp.
Jedi, I'm glad Master Ares is alive and his own self. Best get back to Anchorhead myself. Sandrot's acting up and, well, frankly, sort of Miss Darth Nurse's hollering.
Thank you for all you've done.
Good luck with whatever it is you're doing, Jedi. Hope you find this Lord Vivekar.
Not even the scorekeeper could resist. Kaizen and I have come to honor his father's remains. May we have some privacy? If this dusk shadow is so fearsome, you shouldn't be out here alone. Indeed. If you want the glory of a hunt, you must earn it.
Master Ares has reported back to the Council. Good work. He speaks of discoveries on Tatooine. We intend to hear his full report when he returns to Coruscant. Did you discover anything more about the Plague Master, this Lord Vivekar?
Master Ares seemed to think that Vivekar was why he kept remembering Malachor III and his friend Parcanis.
A connection between the events on Malachor III and our current circumstances is clearly forming. The Council will continue its own investigation into the matter. Meanwhile, hurry to Alderaan. So long as Lord Vivekar has control of even one master, he will grow in power.
I understand perfectly.
Good. Do not delay. Every wasted moment works in Lord Vivekar's favor.
Ah. Excellent. We have a mystery. A package was hand-delivered to the ship, no name, aside from mine, no return address. The package contained a letter on flimsyplast, sealed inside a glass capsule. Nothing else.
That's simply fascinating.
The capsule has a marvelously puzzling lock. I've never seen such craftsmanship. Once I get it open and read the letter, hopefully I can assuage my curiosity.
This is so exciting! I wonder who it's from.
Theron's technological work is famous. Perhaps someone's trying to get his attention.
I'll get to work on this lock. If you're right, we'll know soon enough. This is absolutely intolerable. I finally get that blasted capsule's lock open, and the letter inside? Pure gibberish.
Jedi, you can make this all better, can't you?
Listen to this. AH320SH4. And that's just one line!
The message is probably encrypted.
Yes, that's occurred to me too. But all our deciphering attempts have failed. AH3. Ah. This isn't a message, it's a chemical formula. And the letter itself smells strange. I thought it was the capsule, but what if applying the chemical to the letter had some effect?
That formula looks very complex, and you don't have a laboratory.
An excellent point.
Oh, let me make that chemical. I can do it in a snap, and I simply have to know what's on that letter. I'll get started right away.
Last, an answer. However do you do it? Your very presence sparks my inspiration.
You didn't need me to solve this.
I will not hear a lovely woman denigrate her gifts. Let me express my gratitude properly. In private, perhaps.
There's already a woman in your life, Theron.
What Holiday and I have is complex. It has its pleasures, but there are simpler pleasures. No less valuable, but unconnected, so there's no need for concern.
Even so, I don't want to risk hurting Holiday. I'm sorry.
Then we were not to be? Please excuse me.